After so many years of teaching piano and chamber music in different institutions and different levels, also in postgraduate courses, I felt an urgent necessity to create a group session. This class was established to elaborate all the problems which I have recognized during the individual classes. That was my hope, to cure all the problems, what will help us to express the freedom of the artistic expression. What kind of problems are these? Physical cramps, stiffness, stress, fear from opening up, unbalanced emotions, shy personal attitudes, the lack of knowledge in stylistic features and forming ability, the enormous blockade between the player's body and its body activity and the true expression of the music. So often it caused great trouble to find harmony among the composition, the player and the instrument. However, the basic requirement of a performer is to know his or her body thoroughly, know very well the body to be able to adjust its movement to the musical movements during the performance, during the procedure of the performance. How this program started? 23 years ago, an experimental course started at the Kodály Institute with international students, one lesson per week in group classes, entitled How to Serve Music Through Your Body, Mind and Spirit. We started to do some exercises without instrument to realize how much we knew our own body in action, recognize the anatomy, structure of bones, muscles, well understanding of their balance, their length, energy, natural gestures, and so on. Simply to know who we are. Meanwhile, making the exercises, instructions and explanations were told, such as how to do it, why we make it, and what are the aims of those specific movements. The final aim is to recognize the same movements while playing and to accomplish them freely with profound dedication. The experience of creating musical movements in total freedom without the fear of making mistakes like wrong notes or not using the good technique and so on gives confidence and bring forth to the thorough understanding of the corporal expressions. The real aim is to act properly, to recognize different functions, memorize them, and restore all of it in mind, to be able to repeat it. The physical feelings, the connections among the functions and senses must be used all through the musicianship training. All the movements should carry out with musical thoughts and feelings in mind, such as breathing, forming, shaping, phrasing, feeling the length of the tones, rhythmical patterns, directions in modulations, intervals, line, harmonies, chords. The imagination of the sound by the inner hearing preparation would create the appropriate movement in the playing apparatus, the body, guided by permanent attention and great care and joy.
Hi.
Hungarian musicians are so fortunate being nurtured by the world-famous music pedagogical philosophy and practice of Zoltán Kodály. One of his basic tools of learning and understanding music easily by developing the inner hearing ability is the so-called relative solfa system. This brilliant simplicity gave the idea to establish another relative system which analyzes all the movements, what the music itself does, and also analyzes all kinds of movements, what the musician has to do while performing. This new music pedagogical method is called Relative Movement System, briefly SZO-SYSTEM. Music is an audiovisual art. The title of the film says, "Music is your body." This statement is true only if the musician thoroughly follows the instructions of the written material, understands the grammar and the anatomy of the music, like the rhythm, melodies, harmonies, dynamics, gestures, and so on. In this way, the body of the player can easily pick up the movements of the body of the music. What is the body of the music? It exists in two forms, such as audible form and mute form. For all musicians, the most important aim is to create beautiful, rich sound, full with vibration, which can fill in the concert hall's acoustic. The other side we don't bother too much. Therefore, the relative movement system is teaching the better understanding of the visual picture of the graphics and helps to find the key for the appropriate technical solution with copying the movements and directions of the written lines, etc. It teaches as well how to form and shape the compositions, find their guides, to follow the direction of the musical GPS. Audible music is a performing art. It needs a performer and also an instrument. The instrument has body for making resonance and some has a so-called spirit. Performer has the unity of the three, body, mind and spirit, which must work in total harmony. Performer has to transmit the music to the audience through his or her corporal actions, expressions. The audience will get the sublimate message, the pure intellectual and spiritual meaning of the music. SZO-SYSTEM has a scale of analysis. It has got 8 symbols. The first axiom is the force of gravity, posture of the musician, and tonality of the music. The second is moving away the first motion, rhythm. Third, horizontal plan, lines, melodies. Fourth, vertical plan, lines, spine, chords, harmonies. Fifth is showing a mirror, sense of symmetry, proportion. Sixth, arch, contrasts, forming, breathing, elasticity. Seventh, directions, awareness of space, acoustics. Eighth, the conscious mind and body to create sound, finally find the synthesis.
The fabulous thought first, that each of us has this beautiful territory on the earth, that it is just for me. Isn't it beautiful? Yes? No one else can take it from me, even if I move, but that is me again. That is just for me and I don't need to pay for it, should I? I have my fantastic energy source, like a tree. May I ask you to copy me? That from down there, I am like a fountain. Power. Say, power. Power. And I say very simply,
the force of gravity helps me to gather myself together, to understand who I am, because it will be so important that from this very natural source I can move out. All right, please copy me with your arms and your eyes. These two things that I am growing into the space. Now I need your soul to feel the sources. And then would you please copy the same with your hands? We can create exactly the same situation in our upper body that in the soul. Now I feel that I am totally gravitated and I'm growing out of myself like a first movement far away. The third finger is unlimitedly drawing the line around me because this is my musical sound and I am guarding it. Behind me. Feel your third finger, very nicely, like fingerprint. This will be your musical stamp. And turn backward and breathe out. Did we already make the second one, the combination? Yes, we did. Because normally what I am asking about gravitation, now I am asking questions about myself. Where is my head? Do I know that it is beautifully seated over my shoulders? Beautiful, healthy. I have a neck. Touch your neck. Horizontal line here. And come back. Then I understand my skeleton, my spine, which is seated this way and vertically gravitated. Now comes the posture of music player. This is my posture. When I'm a conductor, this is my posture. I'm a violinist, this is my posture. The posture means gravitation. And the third level, what I am thinking always about, is the musical gravitation. Just a short example. I have to know what is the gravity for my piece. I used to say by his gravity, his tonality. His gravity is his tonality. It is a scale, la ti do re mi. Sing with me. I am gravitated not just a horizontal line like a scale, but I can beautifully make the sound different if I know that in the meantime, through the scale notes, my harmony will be completed. What is it like? Like if I put this la ti do re mi, la do mi, in a vertical way, it will tell me D, F, E, suddenly the vertical chord. Verticality is a chord. Many linear line, parallel line, or multi-voices is polyphony. But at the same time when they are heard, they completing the chord. But another chord completion is when I'm playing a scale and I know that the composer do. I'm listening behind la do mi and my hand is strong. Because it is not note by note, it is the harmony. It is this beautiful arch. My body is rounded. It knows the total harmony. So I don't need to teach them to be independent because the hand is the owner. And the hand guides this very nicely, linear and vertical together. Beautiful listening. Now what is the next little thing what the music say? I am tonality in D minor. What he said?
diminished fourth. Can you hear? And that's what I want to teach. That these chords are like an action of the feeling of the composer who did one step out his gravitation, D minor. The next step will be like, put it on a silver tone higher, B flat, C sharp, the two columns are black keys, and in the center is E, G. But fa, mi, re, do, ti, scale downwards. The first scale, when la, ti, do, re, mi, went upwards, and it goes backwards. I want to say that for me, the art is something that I know about details, but I have to understand the drive of the whole thing, even this is little masterpiece. My body understands that flat, flat line, white keys, go up to black key, and the upper horizon, he goes back. And I remember all the notes which he was passing, and suddenly I have. Voltem per irtes clavir, exactly the same tonality. And then, taritisila. If I teach myself to this sensation, to this sensibility, and with exaggeration, like art needs, if I taught myself, that these black keys will take my heart, cut my heart out of my body, like this, and then it comes back. Later, when I will play it with not this great circus, like, you know, showing off or passion. But my body was taught how the two parts inventions and three parts inventions and voltem per irtes clavi and what way Bach is thinking. Gravitation, stand up, please. La ti do re mi fa si fa mi re do mi la. Think about your skeleton. The backbone is an exclamation mark. Is my symmetry line? Yes. This is my answer to the vertical. Yes, and with this I can make horizontal. That's wonderful. And plus, you understand your gravity. In front of a huge choir, you can be fantastically sourceful for their sound. If they feel that the conductor is not enough strongly carry out her thought, they cannot sing beautifully like this. Please, clap it. Transmit your thought into your choir. Wonderful. Yes, don't stop it. Don't stop it. Think about it. It is never stretched out. It is always flexible because you are carrying the sound. Yes, far away. You are a musical thought. You are your sound, not just an action. Now we are experiencing the mirror. I am my own mirror. I know myself well enough to have the courage to be Johann Sebastian Bach. Everything is reasonable here. My voice, my face, this is my position. Perfect. I like the neck. Very good. Very good. Now I want the same loose, but totally learned that
I am like a piece of flower.
Ways.
I like your eyes because it's tasting. Yes, I like it. All right, yes. The naughty one, I like the naughty, yeah. Yes, yes, wonderful. Full mouth, mouth. Send it ahead of you. This is your voice. Now we will take breath. I'm ready, please. Ready, speak. Quick tongue, yes, bravo. Quick tongue over you, over yourself very freely. Fantastic, I like it. Yes, 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 yes. Don't take any more breath. And when it is going out, it goes. Then the next one. Ready, go. Finish. Muscles are breathing as well. Muscles and everything. My shoulder, oh, don't be stiff. I'm totally flexibility, suppleness, relaxing. Just gravitation. Don't think about anything else. Yes, I'm hanging into earth, inside of the earth. I like it. Kanon, I like it. Now you are dropping yourself in me, and we are moving together without any effort. I like it. Now memorize this fantastic freedom. And now I will allow you to drop your arm, but don't make it. Let it happen, yes? And now, very good. And now I want you to think about your back, the chest, and everything is hanging over this gravity. Wonderful. Excellent. Excellent. Drop your arm with a conscious way. Now we are violinists, and whenever we go this direction, we will make a certain beautiful step in a legato curve, yes? So ta, ti, ti, ta, ti, 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 ta, ta. We have to make our discipline. I must be free in a certain strict one bar. And I have to set myself into this fantastic channel through which I can grow up and down, please. Up. Now we feel the gravitation through a linear line of your lying body. I want you to understand the spine like a parallel line of the earth, the ground, and vertical arms which are flying. I need a musical sound among your fingers like a major triad. 1, 3, 5 finger will create a beautiful arch. And this dome-like arch, look at me, please. I create a 1, 3, 5 and they connect into the symmetry. And now I am thinking about that this is like a crown. And then they will make a part. And I draw the line and keep the interval among the fingers beautifully. The two sides.
and touch the fingers together, and we will make a beautiful circling with the elbows. Keep connected the fingers, please, and push one hand toward the other. Then you will understand the flesh, which has minimum 2 millimeter elasticity. This is what we are working to play with. This is the sound quality. And then again, fly above you, circling now a bit more like a wheel. One and two and three and four. There is the one, downwards, downwards. This is exactly what we have to know, the gravitation. Down, down, three, four. Now I want you to take your fingers like this, like a little puppet mouth, little puppet mouse, quickly, to touch the fingers together towards the thumb, to feel it, how active I can be. I am flying over my gravitated body. I am able to do quick rhythm. I say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3. The 8 is accent. 8, 1, 2, 3, but we practiced on 2, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and last will be, and four down. Now I am collecting it. When they will come closer and closer, I already feel the magnetic space of the sound. Now apart again. Open it, listen the harmony, what you create. Keep the sound alive. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's a musical preparation, anticipation, emotional climax, and then I teach myself how to come back. Ready? And 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. What are we practicing now? The space awareness. The last but one. Symbols and rules, that's it. And outside of you. Now we will do it with crescendo. And know how big your arms are and the circle, long arms, but the circle is big, enormously big. Up and. And I want you now to dare to jump forward, because this is exactly what I want. We are learning now the sforzato, how I can make the sforzato like the target of something. The skin, how much you have to allow yourself to make the crescendo. Now we will do it very quickly. I want, for the three, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3. Very quick action. Yes, and suddenly understand sforzato piano, forte piano, forte piano. The sound has body. Listen, don't make crescendo, nothing. Elbows, I don't like. Flexible, other side. Listen. Round. How far away. Pianissimo. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. With a smooth way, we are doing the target and come back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I need your arm a bit forward. Absolutely. Wonderful. Yes. ta ta ti ti ta ti 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 ta ta. Now the hand ti ya ta ta ri ti 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 ta ta. Ram pa ri ti ta ri ti 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 ta ta. Wam pa ri ti ta. The Spanish ta ta ti ta ta. Now, Antonio Gades. Lengths of the arm, we'll say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ready. Experience how long the arms are. Ready. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. One more time. 1, 2. Bravo. The crescendo is gradually growing. And decrescendo is a gradual disappearance, not suddenly. Yes? So I want you to hear that we were together making the decrescendo and crescendo. So it will be the breathing choir. Ready. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, now we are swimming silently and experience fingers. Yes. Bravo. Around you, the energy, the aura of music spreading. And I like very much how you are making the body balance forwards and backwards. And the arm is, yes, beautiful. You are part of the room. Do we know about oxygen? We are flying in the oxygen now. Aren't we? Not just breathing. God's precious aura.
We have to feel it's very strong and stretch out, back. Everywhere else is very loose. You must be very loose. You are throw it away, very far, back. Far away, back. And so far, the farthest, like making hypnotizing someone. And then in this rhythm way, very rhythmical, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All your fingers like light radiating like right. Your music is very far away. You will stop over there. And then you will relax, relaxing in legato. You are very, and then you drop your arms. The other side, throw away, relaxing. So supple, you are pulling back the elbow towards you, it's good. Then two sides, with two arms, you do exactly the same like a waterfall. I like it very much. Now we are clapping. It's a musical sound of clapping making. You are making resonance from the elbow. It has to be learned which side of the arm is above and under. You are just thinking about the sound. It's good. When the two hands feel apart, you are caressing. And you are pulling away the space. I'm pulling very far. Why don't you do it what I'm doing? In this position, I start and my hands are turning in total opposite direction. That is a magnetic space. It's such a great energy in between. Then I throw it away and then I drop. I would like to ask you, your face as well, it has to be very much loose and your jaw is dropped. I'm just thinking about my spine, my backbone, yours is a standing up position and you are a sitting position. It's two very different positions. Then when you will sit down, everything is a great harmony together. You must think about your belly button now and you will pull upward. And the symmetrical line
Very far, very high, over the ceiling. I will cut the ceiling, and then I am stretching, and then very nicely bring in, I hold the sound. Don't stretch out totally. It's always like something I hold, a silver tray in front of me. And then under my jaw, I pull it, and the elbow is hanging very loose. Your shoulder should be loose at all. I like it very much because from the shoulder, like a marble stone, you have to stretching out very far from your trunk. We are bringing back. You both has to be relaxed. Don't hold my hands. I like it so much, what I feel. You are very much inside of your own body. Please drop it. I like it very much. Now I want 5 fingers, let's say 10 fingers, toward each other, and they will find each other, the symmetry, and I grab it. Now I understand my body symmetry. It's a round, beautiful tone, what I am imagining. Therefore, we did the previous exercises to feel the energetic power. I like it very much. It's good. It's so important that my fingers should know the distance, how far they are from each other, and they are guide the interval. This is an musical interval, and everywhere else, you have to be very loose. Now, I start to make a rhythmical drop. I like it. I like what I hear. Please come, come more. More in front of you, to don't rush in, don't make accelerando. You have to hold it very far from me. I'm listening. Whether it's far away, is it still my arm? And the crescendo background. And pianissimo. Now I make ritenuto. I'm just watching. Make the coordination, but the feeling will never change. The sense of touch will be never changed. Now I don't like it. Please connect it both. And inside of your own body, one hand is your body, and the other hand is an instrument. This is your piano. These 2 fingers connect, and then I relax, but the relationship between the 2 fingers, the touch, the very important preparation, being ready to understand how heavy the arm will be when it will be dropped in the keyboard, into the keyboard. Your eyes must be closed, and you are hanging inside of your own core. Thank you very much. I'm just thinking about the lines, the broken chord, F minor, and the direction of my arm. And returns piano. One, two, gesture. Lovely. Thank you. you so much. It was very much better than last time. I would like to ask you to do, don't play it aggressively, but the movement in between the two arms will create a lovely sound. Two opposite movements, black keys and white keys. It pulls, they move together. But with the rhythm, you must be very punctual. 8 note and 16 note. I'm not nervous at all. I relax. They are changing up the position. Now I'm relaxing. And quick movement. I don't push the 16 note. It's not allowed. No fortissimo. I have to arrive to the accented note. Powerful change in between the elbows. Now jumping. From this movement, A flat centered, and the other way around. Do you understand that happening? And you are just listening. The joy, no panic at all, no agitato. You have to enjoy the two powerful change in between the two directions, even though the melody is unison, but the movement is opposite. You will take a breath. Good. Pull down. Good. Hold. Relax. Yes. And you don't need to play in presto, absolutely not. It's very good. I'm relaxing, I enjoy, and I allow my piano to sound and make the resonance. This is an enjoyable music making. Not sideways. Too much power. It's sliding up and then the arrive.
Certain moment I feel that I am on stick legs, yes, in the Venetian carnival. I'm walking on stick legs and my legs is rooted in the harmony. Thank you. drive on the happy andante. Please, will be my husband. And please, yes or no. Yes, tea and question, smell in silence. And then both sit in unison. Positive thing. Yes, my dear. And then and this will be continued. And I hear the harmony. This is twisting this way and the other way around. Yes, and this, suddenly this is a statue, a beautiful couple. This side is the woman and the other side the man. So they are melted in each other. So, and then one, two, three, and the sentence is called question and the semi major. And suddenly, three times pianissimo, and the arpeggio, and dolcissimo. What else he can? Più lento. What else he can? Una corda. And I'm totally melted, you know? And this is not the other thing like our beautiful Mozart. But it is sad above. But this is a peaceful major and the breathing of the core. If I don't breathe the pattern of rhythm, ta, ta, ti, ta, six, 4 meter, can we do it? Ta, ta. I am using my arms so kindly, in and out, and suddenly the rhythm makes this bodiless freedom. Please just show this and then make it. Hang, 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 hang. Like a water, you pour out a jug of water. Fantastic! Pedal up. This is written. So the pianist or the player must demonstrate the notation, what the choreography says. I almost was running after your bride. Okay. And I am sorry to touch you. If you are not seated well here, you cannot be. I am the water of arpeggio. The arpeggio is running through the keyboard pad. I am G major. And back and forth, right side. That it turns back. Fantastic! Now you do what is written the same way, not earlier than the tie says something. Oh, yes! Ah, soprano. Absolutely, absolutely. Happy and question. Absolutely, and moreover, it will not rush, but flourishing, the cello solo. And now say, aha. Yes, always new thing, but he says, aha. Church bells, it's and happy. Emotion, passion, passion, now it's passionate, molto marcato, a rallentando, a piacere, ai ai ai, ai ai ai, now, something, yeah, not such a gentle mood. You will become old in a marriage still, but now you are young, some passion is still behind. Yeah. What? Aha! 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 I see. I like it because it was twisting. Silver tray. Wonderful. Listen, full mouth. Uh-huh. One more time, this chord. Because after we had G major, we are coming back to the normal, the tonality, the gravitation to E major. Dominant. I'm gravitated. You cannot lift my arm up because it's hanging, it's gravitated. And then over there, you know how he plays? He plays, he shows the thumb. The dominant seventh is here, and this is it, to sit it. Absolutely. Then you can show the changes. Decrescendo. Your T back. Tiri, your T. Tiri, more T. Your T. Your T. Bam. Tim, da, dim, tim. Listen. We lost the bottom. Because this is a normal. Can you hear all the church bells? Like Rachmaninov will do it later. You play Rachmaninov. Lee, can you hear all the sounds? Pedal change. We are in total tonality.
Thank you. comes back, and then... So please, the knowledge about the distance will make it lento. Flying with the oxygen column underneath, and your hand is on, this is my singer. And underneath, this is a beautiful accompaniment of the floating harmony. And if you feel it like this, it's a fantastic position for Polish dance. This dance is a Polonaise, and this is a head. This is a position of the folk tradition of the Polish dancing. And Chopin knows it. Sit down, please, again. And with this attitude, if you play, it is so interesting to understand. This is Chopin. Play the second subject. Listen.
Beautiful,
look at him. What a sound.
I know the leading note, G sharp to A. But this has its fantastic drive, and you have to taste and smell each chord one by one and agree leadership. Smell it. Therefore, coming into this full idea that I am using with total pressure all my five senses to serve the sixth. And if I do not make it perfectly, I am unsatisfied, I am not happy. So I have to know that what it means for my muscles that I am rooted in this frenetic E major. And how long the E major is going with its beautiful forte. If it wouldn't be written forte, I know that it is forte because he doesn't allow me to finish earlier than I read the top E. Yo? And stay underneath with your instrument. Now you come. I want you to stand on this side. This because this leg is a fantastic partner to your instrument. And if you feel it that this side is totally gravitated, please play it without the standing on your right leg. Lift it up. Lift it up. What is a bird like? What is the name of this bird who is only standing? Absolutely. The stork, would you please? Beautiful stork. would you please to understand that it's possible and the sound will be reasonable. Do it. Listen, the sound. Amazing. Amazing. Fantastic sound. Spring is coming, so the birds are here. This is it. This is such an essential thing when we go to the kitchen and it's a lovely smell around, and you say, I can try it, I can taste it, I can eat it. And big mouth like a Big Mac. You know, this is it. Taririm, tararim, and another one. You have to take a breath for the other one. And start again, because otherwise it is not expressive. Please, do it. Long bow, long, backwards. Up. This is very much better. Downwards, down. Intensity, high up, drop. That's it. Fantastic. It affects on her sound. Stand, move, long bow. Don't bend over, you need. Wow! Together to finish. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Now I have something to say. So it guides me up. Like somebody, like I would pull you with a violin. And then it's so lovely to understand.
went over there and comes back. If I don't satisfy this project with the bottom C, I don't know the relationship to somewhere, to my tonal note again back. And it relatively shows how far I have to go and how it comes back. Guide the upper arm with this, doesn't matter the thirds, it is not a matter of technique. It is I divide the two parallel and I say, she can't read me. And then you wouldn't say, the third finger is a cut line. And I'm just busy with this side, and I guide this side, and the other side of the hand is light. Please, draw the line with the top voice. Not enough. Better. Yes, something like that. And still you are flying away. It's not a, it just is, can I ask you to do, all of you? Like a chain, yes, yeah? And then this is the left hand is the organ point of C. And with the right, I am drawing the centimeter. And I go back to the climax A, and then it will return. And then they breathe out together. And then da-da-da-da, something farewell button. This is it. And drop the C, put it down. What a sound! What a sound! Without pedal, it can live 2,000 years. Archive. So, can you hear that as soon as we don't think about just the keyboard technique, but I think far away, I let myself be free from these little tiny points. I'm just reading really, that's what I said, GPS.
Because she has to start in largo, like a background, like a beautiful arc. And she has to speed up just to the a tempo. Then, but the a tempo is really adagio. It was almost andante. So very, the eternity is speaking. So thank you. One-di-di-dum-di-di-di-dum. More freedom. Rhythm yum di di di. I don't force the second, third, and fourth, but one swing and yum di di di, yum di di di. Right? And not yum di di di, yum di di di. I would move too much, but just the more length of the arm and the melody point out more the melody, and the other notes are not loud.
SZO-SYSTEM, which is the relative movement system, emphasizes on the body awareness in music making. As a musician, we have to be aware of our body movements in music making and also follow the directions of the music notation. We have to understand the music at its choreography, which bring us to different directions, for example, vertically or horizontally. And also it brings different expressions and suppleness, the breathing. We have to be aware of the placement of your arms, fingers, wrist when you play the music.
I think one of the most important things I've learned from Orsolya this year and last year as well, has been the way in which your whole body and your whole mind is involved in piano playing. She really finds ways to explain how from your feet up to your head and your back and your arms are all involved in the sound you produce and the musical phrasing you want to produce. She also has a very particular talent for creating a really good atmosphere in the class, an atmosphere that really brings you much closer to the composer and to their intentions.
I am inspired by my piano teacher, who is very incredible, and she always mentions that what the composer says and what the period says. Besides teaching beautiful technical things, she is like a bridge between composer and me. So when I play with her, I can feel, understand the composer very deeply, and I can floating in peace. So I want to mention that the process here is fabulous.
Everything Orsolya teaches comes from the music. The music dictates the movement, and then in turn, the movement helps to bring out the music. I feel that she receives divine inspiration for all of the music that she plays, and then she transfers that to me through her words. My favorite quote from Orsolya about Bach: wisdom, simplicity, harmony. And I will never play Bach as well as I am playing Bach now.
One of the biggest lessons I've learned from her is body awareness. And through body awareness, it has made me a better pianist and always thinking about gestures and using my body to produce kind of sounds as required by the composers.
I must confess that leading and teaching this course is always a great privilege. To see both the personal and professional changes on my students is pure happiness for me. To be a witness of their opening up, to see the joy in their eyes, to look at their smiling faces gives real pleasure for me. We are going through together on the road of discovery, and I am very, very grateful to all of my students for that. To recognize the moment of understanding their body's actions, like a never-felt sensation, is worth everything. To see how the cognitive mind guides them later to use the learned process during the music performance is also a very good feeling. This holistic training helps to open up individuals to discover themselves and find freedom in the great discipline while serving the composer's ideas. The noble value of the music crystallizes and forms a personality, and at the same time, by performing it, offers a total, healthy, physical recreation. In this film, you could see only some examples, but the discovery is infinite.